Welcome back to Nightline. I'm so glad you chose to stay with us. We're thrilled that you did. And we're glad to be back too. We're going to be singing some songs in just a few minutes. But right now, I just want to remind you that we have prayer partners here. And they are receiving calls. So if you have a problem that you would like somebody to pray with you about, then you can just give them a call and they'll be happy to do that. Or you can go online, WGGS16.com, go to prayer and click on that, and you can put in a prayer request. You can put in a comment. You can put in a praise report. We really love the praise reports. And I'll tell you what we really, really love, and that's when somebody gives their lives to Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. That's the most important thing that anybody can do in their whole life is to give it to Jesus Christ. And as we're singing these Christmas songs and as we're going to be inviting you to join with us, I want our hearts to be on Jesus Christ. You know, I like Christmas presents. I like to buy them. I like to get them. I like to decorate. I like the lights. I think they're glorious. I love lights. And I like all the decorations. I probably put up too many, but too many trees in my house. But I love it. It's all wonderful. And it all just seems so peaceful. But you know, really, it's all about Jesus Christ. And the times that we go and do concerts here and there during the Christmas season, it is so wonderful to feel the Spirit of Jesus Christ in our midst. It is just so wonderful to be able to do that. And that's because of Christmas that we have Jesus in our lives here and now. Carlin is going to sing a couple of songs for us right now. I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day is going to be the first one.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day. They're old familiar carols play. Mild and sweet their songs repeat. Of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And the bells are ringing like a choir. Despair, I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said. For hate is strong and mocks the song. A peace on earth, goodwill to men. But the bell. Way the world revolve from night to day. A voice, a chime, a chant sublime. A peace on earth, goodwill to men. And the bells that ring like a choir they're singing. And with our hearts we'll hear them. Oh, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Do you hear the bells they're ringing? The life the angels singing. On earth, peace on earth, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
No, that's what he came to bring. He came to bring peace on earth and goodwill to men. And the beautiful thing is he's still bringing peace on earth and goodwill to all men, not just a few, to all men who will receive him. Peace on earth, goodwill to men. You might have heard that song before in a poem, and it has very old roots, and the next song does too. O come, Emmanuel. I can't remember how old I was when I heard this song at first time, and it didn't mean as much to me then as it does now. But the Jews were singing then, O come, Emmanuel, come, Savior. Come, Messiah, save us. Now we need to sing, O come, Emmanuel, save us. Save us from our mundane, our just the normal day-to-day. Just bring us to a higher plane. Save us from our sins, Lord. O come, Emmanuel.
Praise God. Emmanuel God with us. And he's still with us. You know, Jesus said when he left his disciples, he said, I'm not going to leave you comfortless. I will send you another comforter, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God. And we are not left comfortless. We have Emmanuel in the person of the Holy Spirit. He is God with us and God in us. That is amazing to me. We're going to sing some Christmas carols. Hope you'll just join in with us. And the first one we're going to do is Joy to the World. Sometimes you might think it's a children's song, but you know, it's really not. It's really not a children's song. It just talks about our Savior being born as a child, away in a manger. It's really an invitation song. It invites us to come. Come into the presence of God. You can enter into the presence of God wherever you are. And it says, oh, come, let us adore Him. Thank you. God is so good to us. God is so good to us. And, you know, Jesus came, He surrendered everything. He gave everything for you. He gave everything for me. He surrendered His life. He left the splendor of heaven knowing His destiny. And yet He still came for us. And He asked of us if we want to receive His salvation, if we want to receive righteousness and His glory and His peace, then we need to surrender our lives to Him.
Amen.
And we're going to sing one last song. And as we do, just surrender everything to Jesus. Surrendered everything to Jesus Christ, I invite you to do that right now. You know, it doesn't matter how old you are. Some people think, well, I've just waited too long. I can't surrender it to Jesus now. Yes, you can. There's no being too old or too young to do that. Jesus wants you to. He's asking you to come to Him. And He's asking you to surrender. Yes, He's asking you to surrender your life to Him. And when you do, it's wonderful. I remember when I got saved at 11 years old. And I knew. Nobody had to tell me something drastic, wonderfully drastic, had happened in me. I was fresh. I was new. I knew Jesus Christ. And He had come into my life and changed me completely. When the Scripture says you become a new creation, it's right. Scripture's always right, but it's true. I became a new creation, and you can too if you haven't. You may say, well, I'm too young. No, you're not too young. You're not too old. You're not too anything. Jesus wants you to come to Him, and I praise God for a salvation that was just handed to me. I praise God that this lady gave her life to Jesus Christ. It's the most important decision anybody can ever make. It has changed my life so completely. It changes everything I do. It changes the things I say. It changes everything. And I'm just asking that you would do that. Lord, I pray that you would just open the hearts and the minds of people, Lord, who need you. God, I pray that you would draw each person to you. Draw them, Lord God, to come to you and to know you, not just as a little baby in a manger, but as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And that's exactly what happens. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. And what better time to give Him your life than at Christmas time, the time that we celebrate that He gave His life for us. And just as he gave and he left behind everything, he says, come and follow me. Do you remember him telling the disciples that? Come and follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. So once you come into the kingdom, once you surrender your life to him, he'll make you fishers of men. He'll help you to be able to go out and make more disciples. That's the way it works. The gift goes on, and the gift goes on, and the gift goes on, and the gift goes on, if we will just allow him to do that work in us. If we'll allow him to do that work through us. Oh, he's so good. And I thank God for Christmas. I thank God for Easter. I thank God for his Holy Spirit and all the wonderful things that he has done in my life. And I pray that he'll do it in yours. Good night from Nightline, and have a very Merry Christmas.